fast. Look at those little hands. Those hands are just like our hands. They eat like fruits and vegetables and things like that. And they're so, actually, you would never even hear a leader if he jumped right by you. And then again, they'll use that tail to hold up in the air and locate other leaders. I think you're just magnificent. They were killed by the tens of thousands. It's not just a porcupine, it's a prehensile tail porcupine. This porcupine is from South America. We have a North American porcupine. This is the smallest of the porcupine family. You remember Walter Matthau, who's an actor for him? That had a nose like old Walter's. Look how she picks him up underneath, see? Underneath there, there's not any quills. And if she would have sick herself with those quills, they would go in her with a bar. You want to show me? You just start the show? And Kathleen lives in England, and she's over here doing some shows right now. And as a little girl, she helped raise a lot of animals in our home. A lot of animals, leopards. My daughter Julie, who's at home, helped raise this animal at our home in Ohio. Kathleen now lives in England and does a show. She just got back from Namibia, Southwest Africa. And she'll be doing a lot of shows here as I get older. You can imagine I just can't keep up anymore. It's about $60,000. That's why the snow leopards on the verge of extinction. We don't even know really how many snow leopards are left now in the wild. There might be only about 100, there might be 50, there might be 400, we don't know. There probably aren't three people in the world. George Schaller is a person in New York, one of the few people in the world that have ever seen a snow leopard. Because they live on the rocks. Their feet actually have fur on them. It keeps their feet warm. And when it gets real cold, the snow leopard will get down on the rocks and put his tail, his tail is so long and fluffy. He'll wrap himself up with the tail and stay warm when it gets to be 50, 60 below zero. Susanna's told this armadillo to work. This armadillo eats worms naturally. They dig in the dirt. They're both the same family. The two most sloths. The nine-headed armadillo, this is a very prehistoric. And they live in the trees. All their time is in the trees. They have a prehensile tail. You can see there. A long prehensile tail is nocturnal, and they have little scent glands. They have little scent glands under here that use for perfume. The natives actually kill this animal and use the scent glands for perfume. The palm scent will eat like little birds, little snakes, eggs, just about anything you can get, it will eat. You don't see this, as I said before. They're not really a rare animal, but this animal is very hard to see at nighttime in that part of the world. Thank you, Pat. I guess it's called just the Himalayas. This is a clouded leopard for Asia that lives in the jungles. The clouded leopard again, there are only about 300 left in the wild that we know of. It grows from about 90 pounds. The clouded leopard spends its top 90% of its life is spent in treetops. This animal is one of the few cats in the world that lives in trees. They say it's almost a missing link between the small cats and the large tigers and lions. And it doesn't get to it. It's a very sleek cat. A very long tail to balance itself in the trees, and that coat is valued at about $80,000 that's still growing. Therefore, that's why it was poached. Today it's because of the loss of habitat, but again, you see this, oh, he's so cute. It's beautiful. You see the clouds here? It's got beautiful patches on it, and that's why they call this the clouded leopard. Gets me again up. That long, and the tail is as long as the cat is when he's full grown. The keys how crazy is the club is soon. And we'll be going to Thailand and other parts of the world. I guess he's cleaning up the garbage left by the other animals. Who knows what this is? This folks is the ground hornbill from Africa. A lot of times when we're filming over there, we see the ground hornbill over there eating snakes, believe it or not, beating around the place. You can tell from the beautiful markings on it. Is that a male or a female? It's a female. It looks like a tornado. What was he eating? Hammer? Me. No, not me. Over here. Do you think he's actually going to jump on that stick? Now there. That's here. We have a lot of animals, seriously, we've never had here at the show before. Sometimes we bring out like little rabbits.
come.
This year, I am with Richard, by the way. We'll be leaving for Germany in September, Thailand in November, and Antarctica in February. And oh, we have a, that's a great hotel. A great hotel. And we have the Red Tail Hawk out there, right?
Oh, that's cool.
Two beautiful birds of prey from North America, folks. The Red Tail Hawk over here on the left. Look at the red tail, obviously. The owl is an animal that actually has incredible senses. People say the wise old owl. It's not that the owl is wise. It's great by the size of a pea. It's that it has unbelievable hearing and eyesight. If all the lights were out of this big room here and there was no light at all, this owl could actually catch a mouse. I think I'll stand back here. This tiger has surely grown. Now, this, people ask me all the time, you know, what about a tiger as a pet or something like that? Let me tell you something. I was here 6 months ago, and this tiger weighed about 15 to 20 pounds.
Wow.
The tiger will gain anywhere from a pound to a pound and a half every other day as it rolls over. But you ask me about these animals as a pet, you can see what starts happening. This cat, this would be 400 to 500 pounds, which is three times the size you see now. Look at the beautiful markings on the cat. Now you can see why the tiger was almost hunted to extinction for its coat. That was stopped back in the 1960s in most different parts of Asia. The problem with the tiger today is that the tiger is a meat eater, all right? And where it's from, especially in India, with so many people, the tiger has very, very little room, very, very little room to live. You know, they have to eat meat. And when a person goes around the tiger, obviously they see that the tiger will kill. That's why they call it sometimes a man eater, which it really isn't. It's just trying to hold its own territory. Therefore, the tiger is killed. If it does kill a person, just like in the Yellowstone Park, a grizzly bear attacks the way they kill a grizzly. So all these animals don't have much of a chance in the wild anymore. Now, the tiger, some biologists say the tiger by the year 2015 will be totally extinct in the wild, which would be a tragedy, I think. You know, it always amazes me how a Rembrandt painting costs $50 million, and yet we have a hard time collecting money sometimes to say a magnificent creature like a Bengal tiger. You have to admit, there's not anything much more grandeur or beautiful than a Bengal tiger with that magnificent coat on there. They live in the jungle, they do like to hunt late in the day, they're not necessarily nocturnal, and they're also one of the few cats that swims both underwater and on top of the water. They also live and kill, and they'll eat putrefied meat. They'll actually eat meat after a week old. Most cats will not do that. They eat the meat that the hyenas get. This cat will bury its meat and come back and get it. I'm not going to let you clap right now, but when these two leave, Debbie and Joe.
They like the